Our primary thoughts at this moment are with the crew and family, and we're doing everything we can for them now. I'd like to recognize the work of the first responders who we work with in the Antelope Valley for their efforts on behalf of the team. We're also thinking of the team members that we have at the companies that have been working on this program. I can say that Richard Branson is on his way. He's flying now to Mojave, and we expect he'll be here by tomorrow morning. Space is hard, and today was a tough day. We are going to be supporting the investigation as we figure out what happened today, and we're going to get through it. Future rests in many ways on hard days like this, but we believe we owe it to the folks who were flying these vehicles, as well as the folks who've been working so hard on them, to understand this and to move forward, which is what we'll do.
This was a pure test. This was not a public event. So I will tell you from my eyes and my ears, I detected nothing that appeared abnormal. I know I was briefed that the plume would look different this time than it had in the past. And it did, but I couldn't detect anything. In fact, there was a pause of about 90 seconds when your colleagues have been calling all morning wanting to know when I knew, and I will tell you that I knew when other things weren't happening. It wasn't because of something did happen. It was of what I was not hearing and not seeing. And so it was, you know, if there was a huge explosion, it didn't occur. I didn't see it.